This is Eden Lindemann with the National Weather Service in Reno presenting an online informational weather briefing on the lake effect snow event that occurred on November 9th and 10th, 2012. Lake effect snow is most common in the fall or late spring when lake water temperatures are warm relative to the air temperature. It typically occurs after the passage of a cold front and when cold northerly or westerly flow remains. The image above shows a cold low pressure system across northeastern California and northwestern Nevada. The cold front pushed through the region Thursday, leaving behind conditions favorable for lake effect snow to develop. Let's take a look at the elements required for lake effect snow to develop. The elements needed for lake effect snow are instability, moisture, lift, and wind direction oriented along a long fetch of the lake. The picture on this slide is from a previous lake effect snow event in November of 2000 at Pyramid Lake, which really shows the contrast between snow developing over the lake and affecting the east shore with no snow across the west shore. With Arctic air around 10 degrees Fahrenheit moving across warmer lakes around 50 degrees Fahrenheit, there was a large enough temperature difference to create a very unstable atmosphere. As the cold, moist air sweeps over the warm water, it is heated from below, making it even more buoyant. The air quickly pulls moisture off the lake, saturating the air mass and prompting condensation. Clouds develop as the air becomes increasingly unstable, and then latent heat is released, providing more fuel and lift. Upper-level features, also known as shortwaves, can enhance vertical motion and result in deeper convection. As showers intensify, lake effect snow accumulations start downwind of the lake. Wind shear is also an important element when it comes to lake effect snow bands forming. Wind shear is the change of wind speed or direction with height. Light winds with little directional wind shear create better chances for organized bands of snow to develop off of either Lake Tahoe or Pyramid Lake. The next couple of slides will explain which wind directions occurred on November 9th and 10th that resulted in lake effect conditions near Lake Tahoe and Pyramid Lake. The distance that an air mass travels over a body of water is called its fetch. The event on November 9th and 10th had a light north to northwest flow along Pyramid Lake's ideal fetch, which allowed lake effect snow to impact Nixon and the Paw Raw Range. For Lake Tahoe, a west wind along a shorter fetch of the lake resulted in lake effect snow across parts of Carson City and Minden. Although that is one of the shorter fetches, the very unstable atmosphere resulted in stronger snow showers. What resulted from all of the conditions described in the previous slides was some significant lake effect snow across areas highlighted on the image. Highlighted in area number 2, lake effect snow developed southeast of Pyramid Lake and produced heavy snow mainly across unpopulated areas. From Friday afternoon through Saturday morning, lake effect snow developed east-southeast of Lake Tahoe and produced 5 to 9 inches of snow in Carson City and up to 4 inches in Minden, shown in area number 3. On Thursday night, thunderstorms formed in north-central California and strengthened to produce 18 to 22 inches of snow in Janesville and 5 to 9 inches in Susanville, which is highlighted in area number 1. Those snow showers were not a result of lake effect snow, but it shows just how unstable the atmosphere was Thursday night through Saturday morning. Thanks for listening to a summary of the lake effect snow event from November 9th to the 10th, 2012.